Most of us have known each other from the very first day of kindergarten. We grew up together and we're now graduating with a few new additions to the little family we like to call the class of 2012. Things like that really do only happen in a small town. Up until now, we've all been protected by the bubble of the one place we all love to hate. Riverside's offered us the small town protection of a tight-knit community and a faculty that truly cares about our well-being, both of which have worked to shelter us from the cruel outside world. That is all gone. I will no longer have gym teachers who accept me and my non-existent volleyball skills or my inability to swim properly. I will the guidance office will no longer be an acceptable excuse as to why you did not show up to class, and the authorities won't care if you are a good kid the way Mr. Brooks and Mr. Trojan did. As we were growing up, we all dreamed of finally being a big kid. We were all hoping and wishing for time to speed up. The first milestone we could not wait to accomplish was making it to the high school. Even though we were quickly becoming that big kid, we did not know time to slow down. We impatiently waited to be old enough to drive, old enough to go to junior prom, and then, in the blink of an eye, we somehow became seniors. Even as we made it to senior year, we kept rushing through. We couldn't wait for homecoming, the parties, the games, the senior prom, the senior dinner dance, and we especially could not wait for today, graduation day. Today, our childhood dream would officially be fulfilled, but now that we are here, most of us have little time to slow down just a little bit. Time is described as the indefinite continued progress of existence and events, which is basically just a wordy way to tell us that time isn't stopping. It will continue to rush past us just as it has for the past 18 years. As one once said, it is not about the destination, but the journey. Today marks the end of one journey and the beginning of a new one. As we stood on the stage, we were confident, self-assured, and for the most part, mature young adults. A whole new set of dreams were created, and they were our dreams. Time is not on our side, class of 2012, and it especially is not if the world decides to do end in December. Earlier, we walked with these doors united as a class of high school seniors. Now, we will walk out of them as a group of graduates. Remember the mistakes we made, live by the lessons we learned, impart the knowledge we gained, and live in the moment. We will never be younger than we are right now, so good luck, class of 2012.
We ask that everyone remain seated as we begin our session this evening. One more time, congratulations, class of 2012. Sorry. The alma mater now be sung by the senior choir members. Graduates, please stand.